All right, base never be negative. First point is hint of the problem is logarithm of x base a. This base a should be above 0, not equal to 1. Above 0 means only positive values. Only positive values. Above 0 means, so a greater than 0 means above positive value. A is positive only, no question of negative. This is the condition for logarithm. If base is, so now what we are going to discuss about this point is completed in the logarithm. Now we come to the, so here we can take f of x is equal to logarithm of 25, base is x square. Now base not equal to, what is the base is? Base is not equal to what numbers is the base x square. So base x square not equal to 0. Never be equal to 0, base. Okay, na? Base is not equal to minus 1. Minus 1 square also plus 1 it will become. Minus 1 square also plus 1. Okay, na? So therefore not equal to 1 also. Not equal to 1 also. Okay, na? Therefore, in this one is all the real numbers. X belongs to all the real numbers except 0, minus 1, plus 1. Once again, you can see, Amar. Here, why take the negative, sir? Minus 1, base is not a negative. Now, already we tell that base is a positive. But negative square in X is negative square is, it will x is negative, but it x square will become as a positive. X square will become as a positive. Therefore, I am going to write x is not equal to minus 1 and plus 1 also. Is it clear, everyone? So next, therefore, x belongs to in this one all the real number. 0 is not included. Minus 1 not included, plus 1 not included, except these three numbers. Right, everyone see. Here, logarithm x base a. What is the logarithmic condition in? Base is always greater than 0 means positive. Base is not equal to 1 is the condition in logarithm about base. Base is a is greater than 0 means a must be positive. So no question of negative. Single a is no question of negative. Okay, na? Here, x square is there. X not equal to 0. Base never be equal to 0. Base is not equal to 1. Sir, why we take the minus 1 mean? Minus 1 square will become as a plus 1. Minus 1 square is a plus 1. In the real numbers, hello? Join in class. I came. Right. Everyone see, this is the, so x square minus 1 square will become as a plus 1. Never be, take it as a x is minus 1. Okay, na? So plus 1, never be. Okay, right? It is clear? So next, come to the second part. G of x is equal to logarithm of 5 base x. Here, x is not equal to 0 and not equal to 1. No chance for taking the minus 1 because of it is not a square term. If it is a square term, means we can take minus 1 also. Okay, na? So it is not a square term. Therefore, x is not equal to 0, not equal to 1. Never take minus 1. Right. Here is, in g of x is, what is the x belongs to? X belongs to r minus of 0, 1. No 0, no 1. Okay, now no 0, no 1. Now take the common solution. Already given that both are equal function. That's why take the common solution. What is the common solution is? Now see all the real numbers minus infinity to plus infinity. All the real numbers minus infinity to plus infinity. So in that one, zero is not included. Zero upside is minus one not included. Minus one not included. Upside of minus one. Hello circle. So that means not included. Included means dot circle. So zero not included. Zero not included. And one also not included. One also not included. Is it clear? So all the real numbers except our first condition. All the real numbers except. What is the all the real numbers except? So what is the value? See the we are not taking the minus one, not taking the zero, plus one. Here x belongs to not all the real numbers. X belongs to only positive number. In that one positive numbers, only positive real number. In that one zero and one is not excluded. So zero and one is x belongs to here. See. X belongs to only positive. Lagartha means defined for positive value. Base is R plus only positive value. In that one, 0 and 1 is not included. 0 and 1 is not included. So, sir, rotate camera. Okay. Right. Now it is clear, na? Right. Everyone see. Here R plus positive to 0 to infinity. 0 to infinity. In that one, 0 not included, 1 not equal. So common solution for both is this part. Common solution for both is this part. What is the common solution? Is x belongs to 0 open bracket to 1 open bracket up to 1 part. In between 0 to 1 we have, but no 0, no 1. 1 to infinity we have union. 1 is not included, infinity is not equal, included. 1 to infinity is a, okay, na? Now it is clear, okay, na? So it is clear, everyone. Here why I am taking the minus 1 means square will become, minus 1 will become as a plus 1. But here no square. But here no square, okay, na? But here no square. That why only positive value only we I will take. Okay, na? Clear, everyone? Right. I go through the composite functions. Everyone see? What is the composite function is? So, composite function is. So, already functions is, I will tell that functions is related to the cinemas only, olden day, or that is the remote areas, they will use only one projector. So remote, they will give the 18 reels, 14 reels picture beam, 14 breaks they will give, including one interval. So total 19 breaks they will. Why mean? So FPJ one projector, FA to B is a one projector. That means we see the film is from projector A. We see the film is A to B part. So from A titles to B part is completed. Next projector, G is the another projector starting from B to C part is completed. So including here, so starting where it is cut from there only it will be started. Where it is cut from there only it will be started. Okay, na? So this is called composite function, means cyclic order it is rotating. First F, next G, okay, F to G and G to F rotation is going on. F to G, next G to F, F to G, next G to F will go. Therefore, composite function is a circle, it is a rotating. First projector, next second projector they will on, next again first projector they will on, next they will on the second. Cyclic order is going on. Therefore, cyclic order, that means circle representation is a composite function. First to G, next to where we are going, G to F. That's why we can write second function to first, second projector to first projector, second projector to again first projector. Therefore, F to A, A to B, G to B, C. Then composite circle is a G circle. Second to we go through the first projection. Therefore, G circle, what part is completed means A title to C part is completed. So A to C is complete. Don't write F to F circle G. Why circle means rotation is going on. Rotation. So first G to F, again first where we go, second to first we can go. Therefore G circle F to A part to C part is completed. That is called composite function. Now it is clear. Composite function is a two projector cinema system. Two projectors is there being Ramanuja, we tell that first projector we put the reel from A to B. Second projector start from B to C continuous. Then it is a rotating first projector to second projector to first projector, again rotation. Therefore, composite function is a cyclic order, rotating. Therefore, but representation is where we come from the first projector, means second to first projector we are coming. Therefore, G circle F is a representation. G circle F to A part to C part is completed. F circle C don't write. F circle don't write. Because of we come to the first, second to first we are coming. So F circle G right means F to G is going, but not coming to the again back. Not coming to the again back. So G to F means second to first one we are coming. We are coming again back. That is the reason. We are coming back. It should be C circle A. Okay. It is a C circle A also. Okay, na? Yes, C circle A also. We are telling that. So we what part we can see means in cinema. I came lately. I will ask person. Means he can't tell titles, he can't tell nothing. Nah. He tell that now only this part is completed, sir. Now only this part complete, this is going on continuous. Nah. But he can't tell the first one. Say last part he will be tell. Okay, nah? So in last part, that is the C to A only. Okay, nah? Don't write C to A. So only function should be write down. So G circle F means again we are coming back from to G to F we are coming. So come back is required. So it is a rotation is complete. F to G means half circle only. F to G means half circle only. But circle is completed when G to F is rotating, that circle is completed. So circle completed from G to F only. That's why we write like that. Okay, na? Right. Clear that? Right. What is the composite function? Now see the. This is the composite function, is clear now everyone? So now, so this is the F projector, G projector, A set to B set, F is the A to, this is the F. So again, this is the G projector, so G to C, this is the G. Now we can write one circle is completed. When circle is completed, G circle F. So one circle is completed, G circle F. That's why we can represent. So F to G means half circle only. So G to F means circle is completed. G circle F, circle is completed. From G to F, what part is completed means A part to C part is completed. Okay, nah? Here A is the domain of composite function, C is the codomain of composite function. A is the domain of composite function, and C is the codomain of composite. This is the domain. This is the domain. This is the codomain. This is the codomain of the composite function. Therefore, so A we can put in the projector. So G X belongs to A set. X is the A set. A set element is the X and C set element is the Y. X belongs to A. G circle F at X. So G circle F at X. So X only, domain element only we put in the projection. Then image will get, codomain element we can get. So this can be written as G circle place in the bracket. Circle place in the bracket. So F of X. F of X. This is the definition of the composite function. Is it clear? So everyone, a domain element we put in the projection, then only we get the codomain element. So G, X is the domain element, X put in the projector, G circle F, G circle F of X. This can be written as a G bracket of, circle place is the bracket, circle means of, so bracket, so F of X we can write. That is the composite function is that. Next, what is the property of the composite function? Now see, F is 1, 1, and G also 1, 1, then G circle F also 1, 1. F is 1, 1, G is 1, 1, G circle F also 1, 1. Okay, na? F is onto, G is onto, then G circle F also onto. Next, F is bijection, and G also bijection, then G circle F also bijection. That means what we have to understand means F is 1-1 means G must be 1-1. F is 1-1 means G must be 1-1. No question of onto. F is 1-1 means G must be 1-1. F is G circle F also 1-1. F is onto means G must be. That means G following the F only. G is a follower of F. F is 1-1. Immediately G also 1-1. F is 1-1. G never be onto. That's it. What is the proper definition? So we write on the definition is now see the proper definition of the composite function. So this is the F is a mapping from A to B and G is a mapping from B to C. Then its composite function is if F is a mapping from A to B and G is a mapping from B to C, then its composite function is that its composite function is G circle F map A to C. Immediately G circle F domain element is the X. This can be written as G of F of X. This can be written as a G of F of X is the complete definition. Okay, na? So next property is F is 1-1. G must be 1-1. G circle F also 1-1. Okay, na? F is onto. G must be onto. And G circle F also onto. F is bijection. G must be bijection. No opposite here. F is 1-1. G is onto. Nothing. Okay, na? So no opposite. What is the F? G must be that one. And the composite function also must be that one. Okay, na? Right. It is clear, everyone? Right. Everyone see. One more note point is, we have theorem also. I will explain that theorem also. So one more point is, everyone observe very carefully. We have to discuss the theorem also. After completing this one, we have to discuss the theorem. Three theorems is there. Important theorem. compulsory they will ask in PU examination, and basing that one, so they will be doing some problems in function problem. Some problems should be did by, so only by the composite functions only. Okay, na? Now, what is the first one is, I am going to discuss the point is three set of three functions. G is a mapping, F is a mapping from, everyone see, F is a mapping from A to B, and G is a mapping from B to C, and H is a mapping from C to D. Now we have three mapping. Then what is the associative function? Associative composite function. So associative composite function. Everyone observe associative composite function. What is the associative? So what about the tomorrow? The last class, 12 o'clock, we have na, at that time they will be announced. Okay, na? Present no information for us. So they will be, what is the, so haldena, not a haldena, they will announce by. So last class, what is the last class? They will be announced. Okay, na? Right, leave it. Right, now tell me, what is the composite function for three sets is given? F is a mapping from A to B, and G is a mapping from B to C, and H is a mapping from G. Now I will draw the figure. Everyone see, this is the A set, this is the B set, this is the C set, this is the C set, this is the D set. Now A to B is the F function, B to C is the G function, and C to D is the H function, right? How can you tell this is the, what is the composite function of this one is, tell me. No, question, no, that is the wrong. So this is the, everyone see, for this function is, so this function is G circle F A to C. G circle F A to C, okay, na? This function is G circle F A to C. This part is completed. Only this part is there. Okay, na? This part is completed. What is the remaining part? Is the H tends to C. H is a mapping from C to D is there. Now, reverse order. Reverse. So, circle is completed. H is circle, G circle F, H is circle, G circle, F, starting set is the A and ending set is the D. This is called associative law of the function. So we can do the theorem also. So very simple theorem only. So we can do this theorem also. Okay, na? So this part is clear, everyone. So composite function of three, I will write. Four also we can write, five also we can write. First, we can take these two function. Next, remaining write down. What is the remaining? These two is A to C completed. Remaining is the C to D is there. Now, circle completed. Reverse order. Functions are reverse order. H is circle. H is circle. H is circle. G circle. Yeah. The starting set is the A. Ending set is the D. Is it clear, everyone? Right. Next, we have to discuss the some problems in that one. Next, I go through the theorems. Important theorems is there. Three theorems is there. They will ask any one theorem in the examination. Very simply, I will explain. So very carefully, we can observe. Tomorrow is class is there, means I will explain. No means I will send a video tomorrow. There any if any holiday is came, I will send a video. Everyone see that video. And any doubt is there, next class we can ask, means I will explain that part. Okay, na? I will explain that part. Okay, clear, everyone? Right. Now see the objective questions in that one. If question number one, composite function. If f of x is equal to modulus of x and g of x is equal to greatest integer of x, closed bracket of x means greatest integer of x, then the value of f circle g of minus 1 by 4 plus g circle f of minus 1 by 4 value is required. Everyone observe. So I will do the problem. Everyone see. Hint of the problem is given f of x is modulus of x is given and g of x is greatest integer of x is given. Greatest integer means integer left side we are going, integer we are going to left side, integer we are going to left side only, no question of forward side, only left side only we are going. Next one, f circle g of minus 1 by 4 plus g circle f of minus 1 by 4. Yeah, now composite function is open, circle is replaced with bracket. F of bracket of g of minus 1 by 4. F of bracket of g of minus 1 by 4 plus g of bracket of f of minus 1 by 4. Bracket of f of minus 1 by 4. Composite function, circle is replaced by the bracket. Okay, na? Right. F of what is the g function is the greatest integer. F of, I will write bracket of g function is closed bracket of greatest integer of minus 1 by 4. Okay, now g means greatest integer. What is the x? We can write down is the greatest integer. Plus g of what is the m function is m modulus function. Modulus of x value is the minus 1 by 4. Modulus of minus 1 by 4. F of x inside value take as a modulus of x. F of minus 1 by 4 take with the modulus of minus 1 by 4. Okay, na? F of bracket, this is minus 0.25, correct? Na? Minus 0.25 plus modulus, make it as a positive 1 by 4. Modulus, make it as a positive 1 by 4. Greatest integer. So we go through the, so 0, negative side integer is, after 0, what is the integer negative left side is the minus 1. Therefore, f of minus 1, zero negative side integer is the minus one. So it lies between, so minus 1 and 0 in between, minus 0.5, it go through the left side integer only, minus 1 it will go through the minus 1. Next, g mean bracket greatest integer of 1 by 4, greatest integer of 1 by 4, is it clear? F of minus 1 modulus of minus 1 plus greatest integer of 0.25. 1 by 4 is the 0.25. 0.25, everyone see, 0 and 1 in between 0.25. We go through the left side integer. Left side only means it go through the 0 integer. Therefore, this is the modulus value is the 1. This is the 0. Answer is 1. That's it. Clear, everyone? Anyone have the doubt? Clear, everyone?
Simha, clear na?
All right, one more problem I will take. I will take one more problem. Right. See, if f of x is equal to, if problem number two, object to problem number two, question number two, if f of x is equal to x by root over 1 plus x square, then F circle F at X E. This problem is CM, everyone. Second problem, it is the important problem for object two. How I am doing the problem is C. Here, what is the given in? Yeah, X should be written as this X written as X by root over 1 plus X square. Now, 3F system is there. How I am writing C? F circle F at X. F circle F at X. 2Fs I will take. This can be written as a circle, as a bracket. F of X. So, inside X will be converted as like this one. Here is inside F of X will be converted as inside F of X converted as f of x by so root over 1 plus f of x square. X place is the right on f of x. X place is the right on f of x. X place is right on f of x. Is it clear? Right? Now write down the value of f of x. What is the value of f of x? Is x by root over 1 plus x square. Now downside is root over 1 plus f of x means x by root over 1 plus x square, it have whole square. Right, simplify my everyone. So simplify, this is x by root over 1 plus x square. This is, now this is CMR. So root is cancelled here. So root over 1 plus x square, root is cancelled, 1 plus x square. Now take LCM everyone. So x by root over 1 plus x square. Take LCM, mama. Take LCM, root over 1 plus x square plus x square. 1 plus 2x square by 1 plus x square. Root over 1 plus x square, root over 1 plus x square is cancelled. What we get answer is x by root over 1 plus 2x square. It is the double f of x answer. This is the double f of x answer.